If we are building the perfect F1 driver, what traits are we taking from Max? What traits are we taking from you?
Daniel's nose, for sure. And
you said you were good at smelling.
You can sniff out a win.
Well, I mean, mine is also quite big, you know, so I'm almost touching the visor.
Daniel Ricciardo and Max Verstappen go way back. And they took some time out from prepping for this Sunday's race to give us insider goss about each other that even loyal Drive to Survive fans may not know.
I would say Max is funny. Like, and I'm not saying it's not obvious that he isn't, but he's, yeah, I think...
Well, you don't really see a lot of me on Drive to Survive because I don't like doing it. So, you probably don't get the right side of me because it's just an interview. I'm just sitting down in a dark room and I hate that, you know, so, yeah. And then, I mean, there's always questions about just F1-related stuff, which I anyway don't like to talk about. So it's like, yeah.
What do you like to talk about?
Nothing.
if we just let you be, you'd be in your happy place?
I mean, they put a mic in front of you and, you know, you have to talk about the season, which, you know, have a bit of a casual interaction and have fun, like playing paddle with Daniel is already a lot of fun, for example. And I mean, also some things are just private, right? They, like, people don't need to know what we are doing or what we are saying. And
we need to know, mate.
No, you don't. No, some things are private.
But he is away from the serious interviews. I would say a surprisingly very funny sense of humor.
What would we be surprised to know about Daniel?
I swear a lot.
Hang on. Are we surprised?
Well, I wanted to say one thing, but I'm like, you better not say that. No.
Yeah,
no.
Give it to you.
Yeah. Sometimes it just gets a bit smelly in the room, you know?
Oh, no.
I don't know why that is.
I sweat a lot. I sweat a lot.
That's what it is?
Let's keep it at that.
Okay.
And he's had plenty making him sweat recently. Following a torrid 2 years with McLaren, he was dropped from Formula One completely before he clawed his way back into Red Bull Racing's second team.
I'm really happy to obviously be back here, but to be on the grid, you know, this time a year ago, I was still happy being here, and I think just I was still on that process of, yeah, I guess building up that kind of fire again. But it's much nicer being here as a competitor, yeah, for me at least.
And we know F1 is so cutthroat. Do you let yourself think about what happens if you don't perform on Sunday?
No, like I've been competing my whole life, and even as a go-kart driver, you know, there's always something, you know, whether it's dad sacrificing his weekend to take us to the track, and I know that's money out of his pocket, and there's always like a little bit of a pressure or a feeling of like, yeah, I have to perform. But I think you get to a point as well where I want to perform. Like, it's not because I need to please any other one. It's I want to do it for myself. You know, I do it for the competition and because I believe I can at this level. So, yeah, you don't really think about, oh, what if this, what if that. You know, a season, it's nearly impossible to have a perfect season. So there's going to be races that maybe test you or challenge you, but you don't think or go into a weekend with that mindset.
No such pressure for Max, putting to bed recent rumours he's about to switch teams.
Max, do you see a world where you don't race for Red Bull?
Once I stop driving. good question. You know, the thing, I don't really think about it too much anyway, like what I'm doing in the future or whatever. I know that I have a contract until 28, so I guess that says enough.
I'm asking this on behalf of F1 fans. Do you ever get sick of hearing the Dutch national anthem? It's like, do you? Like, you hear it a lot.
No, I've heard the British and the German one also way too much. I'm very happy, actually, to hear the Dutch one.
But while they're competitors on the track, I wanted to know how strong the Ricciardo Verstappen bromance really is.
Dan, you've got one perfect day with Max as your date. Where do you take him in Australia?
Whoa. A friendly date.
Friendly date.
People are going to get the wrong idea. Aren't they meant to be competitors? Well, I tried to take him to the beach, but clearly it's not good weather. Yes.
Let's go there.
Yeah. To my farm, and we would ride...
Break a leg.
Honda little 110cc dirt bikes. That is what we would be doing all day.
And then we call Red Bull and we're like, we just had a shunt. We can't do the next four races because Daniel's collarbone is gone.
No, don't say that.
Wow. That was a great interview.
You didn't see a standing interview either.
No, I don't know why they were standing.
Looks like Georgie.
They're going to be sitting down a lot.
Spent a long time.
Days, right?
Yeah, they're stretching out.
Do you think the problem for someone like Max Verstappen, like with the whole he doesn't show his funny side, is winning all the time is boring.
It's boring, yeah.
Like being the guy who just always wins. It's hard to have a personality when you're in that role.
Also,
the guy who's struggling. Is
it boring or is it stressful? Because once you're number one, you've got to stay number one. The pressure is there.
Yeah.
If you can be this kind of underdog, this little upstart that comes in and wins, I mean, the pressure's off.
Yeah. That might be right.
Definitely. I don't know. He just spends a lot of time alone in a car. It's just... I don't know. He's probably got not much to say, really.
Do you think he can win every race this season?
Looks that way. Like, he's been pretty dominant.
And
what's the stat? I'm probably wrong, but it's like 25 out of the last 27.
Yeah.
Like, it's insane. Like, we're looking at one of the all-time greats, if not potentially down the line, the greatest of all time. It's crazy.
Can I ask a really dumb question?
Yeah.
Do they, like, listen to the radio or, like, music in the car when they're doing laps?
See, the footy's on Triple M. Let's go!
Cody, FM, the breakfast show.
It's a long time. There's whack on a podcast or something.
Yeah,
or...
one of yours, right?
Yeah, that'd be nice. Bit of mid-flight broadcast.
I'm supposed to overtake, but the secret sound's happening.
There's your answer, sir.
All right. I'm not an F1 expert. Okay.
You can catch more of Max and Dan taking on challenges in Red Bull's Unserious race series. That'll be fun. Head to our website for all the information on that and where you can watch it.